Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, et Spes Nostra Salve. A te clamamus, exules filii Eve, a te suspiramus, gementes et plentes, in ac lacrimarum vale. Ea ergo, advocata nostra, illos tuos misericordes oculos, ad nos converte. Et Iesu, benedictum fructum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome. Now, on this Thursday, the 19th week of the year, if you've been following the daily readings, as so many of you have, we've made this journey through salvation history. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy. Yesterday was the death of Moses. We're going to finish out this week with the transfer of power to Joshua. He's been the right-hand man of Moses. And now God is saying, you are the one who will lead the people. I'll talk about that in the homily today. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, let us call to mind our sin. And so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us and forgive us our sin and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, whom taught by the Holy Spirit we dare to call our Father, bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Reading from the book of Joshua. The Lord said to Joshua, "Today I will begin to exalt you in the sight of all Israel, that they may know I am with you as I was with Moses. Now command the priests carrying the Ark of the Covenant to come to a halt in the Jordan when you reach the edge of the waters." So Joshua said to the children of Israel, "Come here and listen to the words of the Lord, your God. This is how you will know that there is a living God in your midst, who at your approach will dispossess the Canaanites. The Ark of the Covenant of the Lord, the whole earth, will precede you into the Jordan. When the soles of the feet of the priests carrying the Ark of the Lord of the whole earth, touch the water of the Jordan, it will cease to flow, for the water flowing down from upstream will halt in a solid bank. The people struck their tents to cross the Jordan, when the priests carrying the Ark of the Covenant ahead of them. No sooner had these priestly bearers of the Ark waded into the waters at the edge of the Jordan, which overflowed all its banks, during the entire season of the harvest, that the waters flowing from upstream halted, backing up in a solid mass for a very great distance, from Adam, a city in the direction of Zarethan, while those flowing downstream toward the salt sea of the Arabah disappeared entirely. Thus the people crossed over opposite Jericho, while all Israel crossed over on dry land. The priests carrying the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord remained motionless on dry ground in the bed of the Jordan until the whole nation had completed the passage. The word of the Lord. The response, Alleluia.
Alleluia.
When Israel came forth from Egypt, the house of Jacob from a people of alien tongue, Judah became his sanctuary, Israel his domain.
Alleluia.
The sun beheld and fled, the sea beheld and fled, Jordan turned back, the mountains skipped like rams, the hills like the lambs of the flock.
Alleluia.
Why is it, O sea, that you flee, O Jordan, that you turn back, you mountains that you skip like rams, you hills like the lambs of the flock.
Alleluia.
Let your countenance shine upon your servant, and teach me your statutes.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord.
Peter approached Jesus and asked him, Lord, if my brother sins against me, how often must I forgive him? As many as seven times? Jesus answered, I say to you, not seven times, but 77 times. That is why the kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who decided to settle accounts with his servants. When he began the accounting, a debtor was brought before him who owed him a huge amount. Since he had no way of paying it back, his master ordered him to be sold, along with his wife, his children, and all his property in payment of the debt. At that, the servant fell down, did him homage, and said, Be patient with me. I'll pay you back in full. Moved with compassion, the master of that servant let him go and forgave him the loan. When that servant had left, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him a much smaller amount. He seized him and started to choke him, demanding, Pay back what you owe. Falling to his knees, his fellow servant begged him, Be patient with me. I'll pay you back. But he refused. Instead, he had the fellow servant put in prison until he paid back the debt.
Now when his fellow servants saw what had happened, they were deeply disturbed and went to their master and reported the whole affair. His master summoned him and said to him, "You wicked servant, I forgave you your entire debt because you begged me to. Should you not have had pity on your fellow servant as I had pity on you?" Then in anger, his master handed him over to the torturers until he should pay back the whole debt. So will my heavenly Father do to you, unless each of you forgives his brother from his heart. When Jesus finished these words, he left Galilee and went to the district of Judea across the Jordan.
The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We're going to finish out the daily readings this week in the book of Joshua, and they're instructive. First off, we have a transfer of power. Moses has been leading the people for so long. He's an institution. He's a force of nature. He has been leading these people and doing mighty deeds. And now in this transition, God looks to Joshua and says, "You're the guy. You're the next one." So we have this notion here of what's it like to work through change. People of Israel now have got to deal with this. Most people don't like change. This is the first thing. Second thing is, God is still in control. It is the Lord who leads, the Lord who directs. And so Joshua, just like Moses, is following wherever the Lord is directing this whole thing to go. And so it's the Lord who's saying, "This is where you're headed now." And it's a great image. And a lot of people don't realize that the children of Israel walked through water two times, the Red Sea and the Jordan River. And here, it's like exactly what happened with Moses, only on a smaller level. Okay, we got dry ground here. We want to get to that dry ground there. There's a river here. What are we going to do? The Ark of the Covenant. It's not the staff that Moses had. It's the Ark, that box that's carrying the stone tablets of the Ten Commandments. This is God who is leading, God who is protecting, and God who's making things happen. So again, this clear sign to the children of Israel, the leadership changes, but God's grace and strength remain the same. And now they're about to proceed into the Holy Land. That land that Moses gazed upon yesterday before he died, now they're about to enter into it. So we have this sense here of transition, of trusting in the Lord, and this notion now of living your life, this next chapter that is unfolding. And my friends, each one of these steps is true for us today. Life is change, and we got plenty of it. And while there might be seasons in life where things are pretty consistent and move along in their course and their nature, they don't stay that way forever. Sooner or later, things will be different. But do we continue to trust in the Lord through every season, every change, every step? That when we turn the page into a new chapter of our life, do we continue to say, "Okay, Lord, new rules, new situation, but you will lead, you will guide, and I will trust in you." That as the children of Israel make this change, they trust in the Lord. As we face the changes in our life, we trust that God will not only guide and lead us and give us what we need, but help us to learn the lessons at every stage in life, so that we will continue to draw wisdom and grace from what God has to soften our hearts, to expand our souls, to allow us to be more and more like Jesus, loving and serving, forgiving and following. And so today, what's the change or transition that we're facing? We just got to name it. What is it before us that might be new or uncertain? A path that maybe we haven't been on before. May we grab hold of the hand of Jesus. May we ask the Lord not only for guidance but for strength. that we will continue on our journey through life, allowing the Lord to lead us every step of the way. God bless you all. We pray this day for the church, for Pope Francis and our bishops, that they will lead us in difficult and uncertain times to continue to keep our face turned to Christ. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all who are sick. We pray for all who are in need of healing, body, mind, heart, and soul. We pray for doctors and nurses and caregivers and those who bring about healing, that through their efforts and guided by the Lord, the Master Healer, people will find comfort, renewal, and strength. We pray to the Lord. For those on the margin of society, for those who don't know where the next meal will come from, where they will sleep, have access to health care, for those who are often unwanted, neglected, and at need, that through our efforts we might alleviate their suffering, we pray to the Lord. For the intention of this Mass, in honor of Emil and Mary Osako on their 60th wedding anniversary, that God will bless them, protect them, watch over them, we pray to the Lord. For all of you at home, for the prayers you offer in the comment line, for all of us, for the prayers we now offer in silence. We pray to the Lord. Gracious and loving God, look kindly upon us. Hear the prayers we offer now, spoken and silent. We make them all in the name of Jesus, our Lord. O God, we earnestly ask you to bless our diocese
with many priests, brothers, sisters, and deacons who will love you with their whole mind and heart and gladly spend their
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our loving Father. Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right
and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit among them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, James our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress and useless worry, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. bread that I will give, says the Lord, is my flesh for the life of the world. Let us stand to pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace. Thanks be to God. Have a great day.